I had begun to do other songs, and for the most part, all of the songs that I've done since the beginning, I still am able to do. Hold on. Sequence in this song. Trying to find the right sound.
Yeah.
Getting closer. On the town for a while. The money's low and my suit's out of style. But it's alright if my clothes aren't new. I'll say, because my heart is true. She said, baby, everything is alright. Upside, out of sight. Baby, everything is alright. Upside, clean out of sight.
By the time Stevie Wonder had graduated from high school, he'd recorded 12 albums, he'd had 8 top 10 singles, and was not only writing but producing songs. His increasing desire to experiment musically was met with caution by Motown.
For once I can touch what my heart used to dream of.
It was a sound which became a Motown sound, and that worked, and it started working. Now, and it was working for Stevie. And then when he started departing, then I became scared. And I got a lot more to lose now than I had to lose before. And I'm not interested in experimenting too much.
Also met a new musical collaborator, Syreeta Wright. They were married for 18 months.
He had heard a song that I had performed. It was written by Ashford and Simpson called I Can't Give Back the Love I Feel for You. That song was under a name called Rita Wright, and he wanted to meet the person that that voice belonged to, which was me. And he arranged for Paul Reiser, who was one of our top arrangers then, to introduce him to me. From that point, we went in the studio, and he produced, or was to have produced, a song on me called Win Your Love that we never did finish. He won my love, but we never finished the song.
Their partnership soon produced a million-selling hit.
I'm wondering if your love's still strong. Ooh, baby, here I am, signed, sealed, delivered.
what happened with Signed, Sealed, Delivered, we brought it into the A&R department, and another producer came in and heard it, and he said, that song ain't... Okay? And so Stevie was, you know, doing his thing. He stopped, and this look of, we'll see about that, came. It was that kind of look he had on his face. It was such a determined and strong and powerful position that I felt him taking at that time.
We were in Detroit on his 21st birthday, and we had a little party for Stevie, and we sat at the table, and we were having so much fun. I left there that weekend, coming back to California. When I got here, there was a wire from Stevie's attorney disaffirming every contract that he had with Motown. I couldn't believe it. I'm sitting with this man. We were having fun and everything was happy, and I know he loved me because he always showed love. We always had love. And this wire was there with no fur, nothing. And, but it turned out, and I thought, surely, Stevie's leaving the company. He disaffirmed everything, he's 21, now he's going to go out and get bids from all the other companies, and he's going to leave the company. I mean, that's, why else would he do this without telling me anything? And it just turned out that Stevie was 21, and he wanted to show me that he was 21 now, and he wanted a little respect, and, he ended up making me pay him $13 million to sign up another whole new contract with him, which was unprecedented at the time, but probably one of the best deals I ever made.
A lot of people talk about the whole thing of me reaching 21 and everything happened and everything broke and everything this, and I begin to rebel and whatever. Really, it didn't start at 21. It started really... And it starts any time that I get bored with what I'm doing. I just have to say, okay, it's time to do something different now. So I had written My Cherie Amour at 17. I'd written Till You Come Back to Me, that later on Aretha Franklin did, as you know. So I'd done a lot of writing, a lot of songs, and I just felt that as much as I knew that Motown felt they were doing whatever they thought was best for my career, I had a feeling as to how and what I wanted to do.
We still have an understanding. We're still close. It's just that basically now, a lot of things that I want, and I feel that the only way that I can do what I want to do totally in my way of being the best way is to be free enough to do them.
Stevie Wonder battled with Motown for artistic freedom to write.